When the first human species, Homo erectus, emerged in Africa 2 million years ago, it found itself at the start of a great mission to spread out and to specialize into Earth's first neurons, Earth's first nerve cells. I'm Brian Thomas Wim with the Human Energy Project. Our series of short films explores the way humanity is building a planetary nervous system called the Noosphere. As we deepen our understanding of the Noosphere, we develop a collective sense of meaning and purpose for addressing the planetary challenges of our time. One of the essential conditions enabling the rise of the Noosphere is population. In today's film, we show the way a growing population of humans began the process of building a planetary brain of brains. In a developing mammalian embryo, as fetal cells specialize into nerve cells, they gather together in what will become the brain and the central nervous system of the animal. An analogous process has taken place with the Earth as a whole. The first step was to distribute these early humans, these planetary nerve cells, all around the surface of Earth. This was altogether new. Humans and chimpanzees are 99% identical in terms of their genes, and yet chimps stayed in their African forest while humans exploded around the entire planet. Pause a moment and take this in. For 2,000 years, Western civilization has celebrated the heroism of Odysseus as he made his way from Troy to Ithaca. But his heroism pales in comparison to that of the early humans. They left their balmy African tropics and marched 750,000 years to the upper limits of the Asian continent. When they arrived there, they found themselves in an ice age that buried the land in mile-high glaciers. Yet even then they persisted. Some of their descendants made their way to Australia. Others hunted the great mastodons at the Arctic Circle. Still others survived in the snake-infested swamps of North Carolina. As the humans spread over the surface of Earth, each group burrowed into the rhythms of its biome. One group wore the same furs as the brown bears. Another group traveled the same routes as the migrating reindeer. Still another constructed rituals wearing the feathers of birds. And one day they learned to fly like the birds. In all of this, in their cultures and in their consciousness, each group specialized as the human form of their biome. What this means is that communication between two different human groups was the Earth growing in awareness of its different aspects. In a developing embryo, as the neurons connect the cells together via dendrites and axons, there comes the time when the animal's mind awakens. Earth is in that moment. More and more of us are aware of the planetary effects of our lives. More and more of us are becoming aware that our primary challenge is to deepen the vitality of our life place. We are beginning to understand that we are the first sheets of a planetary brain. And you, by watching these videos about the emergence of this Noosphere, are an essential part of this awakening. The way to proceed is present, just as it was present to Homo erectus. As we align our ambitions with the vitality of Earth and pursue our deepest fascinations. We carry forward the heroic action of bringing forth a planetary mind, the Noosphere.